Welcome to another lifestyle video straight out of Cali, Colombia. We out here. We're about to walk to the Parque del Perro, the park, dog park, whatever translation I could use. We're about to go there right now. We're walking there. I didn't know I lived that close to it, but that's what I was told. So which is why I'm taking that walk. I haven't done a video in like 2 days. So we in the neighborhood of San Fernando. We live a few blocks away from here. Actually, I live a few blocks away from here. So I'm just basically monitoring the town, the zone, and so you guys can have a good idea what Cali, Colombia is all about. I'm about to pick somebody told me this park right here is the Parque del Perro, but I had to make sure I asked somebody else. They said go up a couple of blocks. That's a nice honey right there. Ooh wee. Got some nice long legs. So this is a cool, nice neighborhood. Let me zoom out so you guys can see. I don't know why my let me see. Okay, I think now it's probably working better, as it was locked in, it wouldn't let me. So anyways, make sure you guys like, subscribe, and share this video so I could be able to bring you more content out of Colombia. We've been over here for like going on 2 weeks now. It's a lot of motorcycle in the way. I'm crossing the street. I think I'm good now. So I can walk towards Parque. You know what I'm saying? So people, as I'm walking around, people looking at me funny, like, dang, he's gotta be a foreigner. You know what I'm saying? With shorts on, the little camera in his hand and all that. Just in case you guys may wanna know, I'm using the DJI 2. You know what I'm saying? I've seen a lot of YouTubers using that camera, but I think most of the YouTubers I've seen in 2020, they were using the DJI 1, the first one. And this one just came out in October of 2020. I just purchased it about 2 weeks before I knew I was coming here to Colombia. Initially, my trip was for a week, but I decided for me to get more content, I have to stay for a lot longer. So, which is why I purchased this camera, so I could bring you guys the best content out of Colombia. Okay, we here in San Fernando, walking towards the ¿cómo se llama? El Parque del Perro. Okay, don't say I didn't say that. I got somebody calling me. I don't know. Let me see who that is. Probably that Negro Keller. Yo, I can't talk right now, man. I'm filming. Well, coming up. I think I can walk there. They doing constructions over here. And me, I'm walking towards the park. El Parque del Perro. That's what we're doing. There's a lot of... Oh, here is a lot of business around here. I had no idea. as you can see. Pet spa. They even have pet spa over here. If you have your pets, there's spa over here for your pets, alright? So there's different stuff over here. It's a pretty nice area. You know what I mean? Yeah, don't forget to subscribe, like, and share this video. Because if you don't, it's going to be damn near impossible for me to bring you the next video, alright? And it's a good way to grow this channel together, alright? It's your boy, Lifestyle. And like I always tell you guys, this channel is about traveling. It's about my day-to-day life, what I do on a day-to-day basis. Traveling, cooking, sports, video gaming, you name it. That's what we do here. Oh, shit. It's like a bee. Shit, big as hell. I think we have arrived to El Parque del Perro. Sí, llegamos al Parque del Perro. Entonces, aquí hay muchos lugares de negocios. Aquí el Irforno o Itorno, no sé como se dice, pero there's a lot of different restaurants here, businesses. It's very chill, real cool. But we have arrived, there we go, the park of the dog park, Parque del Perro. I have to pronounce it with the double R, you know what I'm saying? So we're gonna walk inside the park and see what's so monumental about it, you know what I'm saying? So I'm also supposed to go to El Parque de los Gatos, the cat park. There's also a cat park here in Cali, and I haven't been to it yet. I also need to go to Cristo Rey, I think that's what it's called. We'll see what it's like. There's nice little palm trees here. I guess that's what these guys was the other day. You know what I'm saying? Parque del Perro. It's up right around the corner. Let's look at this big ass rock. You know what I'm saying? What does it say? It says Vivo something. You know what I'm saying? It's a big ass rock though. Like I said, there's a lot of restaurants, a lot of businesses in the area. Italian stuff. Italian restaurant, pizzeria. There's different pizzeria places here. Those of you who are in Subway, if you let me zoom out. There's a Subway right there. It's a bunch of stuff that you, if you come out here to the park, yeah, and you want to grab something to eat, you can actually buy stuff to eat while you're at the park. Okay, big ass tree. I don't know what kind of tree that is, but it looks very interesting. And they also have like garbage stuff here. I know you guys are like, why is he filming that? I gotta film everything that's in the park, man. That's what I'm here for. You know what I'm saying? We walk in the middle of the park now. Oh, this is the statue, the Buenas. This is why it's called Parque del Perro. Yeah. Now I see, yeah, we are here. Parque del Perro. Let's see what it says here. Monumento al Canteri, Ernesto Bussi, Escultor. Ah, this is why it's called Parque del Perro. Uh-huh. Un perro blanco. It's a white dog. I would like to know why this is called Parque del Perro. You see the monument yourself, statue of a dog. There's, like I said, there's also a park of the cats. Let's see what this says here. Son cosas del corazón. Son cosas del corazón. Barón Rojo Sur. La banda 105. Rojo Capo. Right? They have like nice little palm trees, lights, and all that. Yo, this area is pretty nice. And what's even more nicer about it is the fact that, like the view of the mountains, that's the beautiful thing about Colombia, yo. And you see nice buildings, nice houses in the mountains. Like you want to live there for quite a bit. Now, you may not want to live there for your whole entire life, but it would be a good experience or experiment. Damn, what is this? This look like, I'm trying to see what kind of tree this is. It looks very interesting. If you guys that's gonna be watching this knows what kind of tree this is, please let me know. Let me take a good look at the leaves. Yeah. Please let me know what this is. I would love to know. Okay. I'm gonna ask this young man, what is this called? Señor, una pregunta, por favor. ¿Cómo se, qué tipo de, eso es una fruta?
Amigo, le digo la verdad, yo de plantas cocom.
¿Cocom?
Sí, pero pues no debe ser fruta porque no es comestible.
Okay,
no es como. Es un fruto, pero no es comestible. Hay mucho fruto que no es comestible.
Ah, okay.
Hay muchas cosas por aquí que son como limones.
Ajá.
Pero eso no es
comestible. Comestible.
Coco no es porque no es palmera.
Pero okay.
Debe ser una, algo que no es comestible.
Okay. He said it's a fruit, but it's not edible. You know what I'm saying? There's some fruits that aren't edible. Okay. Okay. ¿Y por qué se llama el Parque del Perro?
Okay. ¿Ves un perro por ahí?
Sí.
Resulta que eso lo hicieron en honor a un perro que era de un señor militar.
Okay.
¿Viste? Entonces el perro murió, era un perro muy querido. Uh-huh. Y en honor a eso le pusieron el Parque del Perro.
Ah, okay.
Eso desde hace muchos años. Y así se quedó.
Ah, oh, okay.
Esa es la imagen del perro, creo que se llama Ted. Ahí está.
¿Se llama Ted?
Ted, sí, creo que se llama. Ah, okay. El nombre. Eso lo hicieron en homenaje al perrito.
Ah, okay.
El militar.
This was a homage of a dog that was owned by a military guy, and it was a very dear dog, and they actually did a homage to the dog, and the dog was named Ted. So just to summarize what he just told me, it may not be the right on point translation, but this is what I summarized from what he told me. Muchas gracias, señor, por... ¿Eres caleño?
Caleño, claro.
Caleño, okay. Me gusta esta zona.
¿Y el amigo de dónde es?
Es muy lindo. Soy de Miami.
Ok. Okay.
Miami, Florida. Allá hay muchos colombianos también.
Muchísimos.
Sí, cubanos y venezolanos. Sí, pero es mi primera vez en Cali.
¿Cali?
Mi segunda vez en Colombia. Yo fui para Medellín. Medellín es muy, muy linda. Demasiado.
Es muy bonita, pero acá en Cali la gente se amaña porque Cali es una ciudad alegre, Cali es una ciudad festiva.
Ah, también la gente.
Nocturna, lo que pasa es que ahorita con el tema de pandemia, pues eso se ha restringido.
Ok.
Pero está aquí rumbe de lunes a lunes, a cualquier hora, a cualquier momento.
Uh-huh.
Ah, es que nos gusta mucho la salsa. O sea, ese tema es importante, hay muchos sitios donde rumbear.
Ok.
El clima es caliente, toda la gente que viene de tierra fría, acá
sí.
Se baña mucho. Tenemos frío, tenemos
la lluvia.
Entonces, okay. No, pero igual Medellín y Cali son ciudades muy bonitas. O sea, en cuanto a infraestructura, obviamente Medellín es más bonita por el metro y eso.
Uh-huh.
Pero en cuanto a ambiente y...
¿Has estado en Medellín?
Sí, sí.
¿Ah, sí?
Claro.
¿A qué parte de Medellín has estado?
El centro.
El centro de Medellín, ok.
Para ir por el lado del estado.
Ok.
Bogotá es una ciudad fría.
Sí, eso me dijeron siempre, que
Bogotá
is cold.
Yeah. La gente que es de allá le gusta su ciudad, pero no, a mí Bogotá sí.
Ah, ok.
Cali, Medellín y Bogotá son las ciudades principales de Colombia.
Ok.
Son las más grandes, las de más infraestructura.
Ok.
Y esta parte pues del sur donde estás es bonita, para los oeste, no sé si ya fuiste a ver los gatos de Tejada, que queda aquí cerquita.
Estás hablando del parque de los gatos, ¿no?
Los gatos.
¿Qué tan lejos de aquí? He's talking about the cat's park.
Si te vas caminando por ahí unos 20 minutos, media hora. Si te vas caminando.
Pero tengo que ser.
Hacia allá, claro. Pues esta que sigue aquí, que llama la circunvalar,
uh-huh.
Esa te saca ya como al hotel Inter, por ahí queda.
Ah, sí.
Está relativamente cerca, ¿no?
Está relativo.
Pues a uno le parece cerca porque.
Ok.
Pero este sector es como bonito, y está la ribera del río Cali, está el paseo, el bulevar del río.
¿Pero puedo caminar por
sí,
allá?
Sí, sí, sí. Sino que aquí hasta allá, pues caminando, como te digo, por ahí una media hora, que te estás viendo como por toda la carretera.
Okay.
Si quieres salir aquí a la quinta, ¿ves?
Sí,
a la quinta. Que es la principal.
¿A la quinta?
Sí, esa te lleva a donde se va a meter por el túnel, no te metes por el túnel, sino que se subís.
Ah, ok.
Seguí derecho y ahí ya te encontrás el bulevar.
Ah.
Es bonito para caminar.
Entiendo.
Dale, mi hermano.
Ok, muchas gracias. Ok, eso es. Tengo un canal de YouTube. Grabó cosas cuando viajo. Muchas gracias por los detalles. Ok, hasta luego. He basically just told it's a nice place. People are always happy. Different places to party. It's hot. Sometimes it's hot, sometimes it gets a little cold, and then it rains. But overall, it's a nice place to be. And he was being very nice, explaining to me. And yeah, he's from here, Cali. And he's been to Medellin also. And he said also, he talks about Bogota. But Bogota is cold, too cold. Like. Everybody always tell me. And he also told me that I could take that street over there to walk towards Parque de los Gatos, but I think I live closer to it. I could take it off the main street on Calle Cinco. So, I showed you guys the park of the dog park, El Parque del Perro. I explained to you, gave you guys a brief explanation. Well, he explained to me and I translated to you that this park is called that because it was a dog that was owned by a military guy, and the dog was I think eventually passed away, so they basically dedicated this park to him. It's been years, quite a while, so which is why it's called Parque del Perro. Well, this is it, guys. Make sure you like, subscribe and share this video, and I'll definitely be bringing you guys more content, especially when I go to Parque de los Gatos. I'm gonna bring you guys more content. I'm gonna show you guys the same things that I just showed you here, probably more. Okay, so I'll see you guys on the next one. Ciao. Ciao, 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 ciao.